بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قيل يا رسول الله أي الناس أفضل It was asked, Ya Rasulullah, who is the most excellent of men? فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مؤمن يجاهد في سبيل الله بنفسه وبماله The believer who strives hard in the way of Allah with his person and his property. This hadith tells us about the importance of jihad in Islam. The word jihad is derived from jahad, which literally means struggle. But in religious terms, jihad refers to the struggle in the way of Allah to spread the goodness and to shun the evil. It is a noble job given to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Holy Quran says that kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar. You are the best nation evolved for mankind because you enjoin good and forbid evil. So the purpose of jihad is to spread justice and goodness in the world and to eradicate and to shun the evil and injustice. It can be done in many different ways, but over here Holy Prophet peace be upon him is talking about two forms of jihad, that is jihad bin nafs and jihad bil mal, like fighting in the way of Allah with your person and fighting in the way of Allah with the arms and all the things to remove all the hurdles in the propagation of Islam. That is also physical jihad. Physical jihad is given a lot of importance in Islam and huge rewards are promised for it. Like Holy Prophet peace be upon him also said, لَغَدْوَةٌ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَوْ رَوْحَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا One day or one night in the way of Allah is better than this world and the things in it. Like physical jihad and spending time in physical jihad is such a great rewardable action that if you will spend only one night in the way of Allah, fighting for the sake of Allah, for the religion of Allah, the reward which will be given will be bigger than all the things in this world, and the entire world is nothing in front of that reward. Similarly, there is a hadith in Jami' Tirmizi in which Holy Prophet peace be upon him said, Al-Jannatu tahta dhulali suyuf, paradise lies under the shadow of sword. And Imam Tirmizi called it a Hasan Hadith. But why it is so that such a man is considered the best in the sight of Allah and Holy Prophet is calling him the most excellent of men? Because if a person is giving the sacrifice of his life and his property, and you know the two most favorite things for a person are his life and his property, and a mujahid is ready to sacrifice his life and he's ready to spend his hard-earned money in the way of Allah just to promote the religion of Allah, and just to seek the pleasure of Allah. So obviously, who can be better in the sight of Allah than this man who has sacrificed all of his comforts and his life and his property? Besides that, we can say that this person is considered the best because when a person does jihad for the implementation of the law of Allah on earth, so the benefit goes to the entire humankind. The purpose of jihad is obviously not to shed the blood of the non-Muslims. The purpose of jihad is to implement the law of Allah in the entire world. And when the law of Quran will be implemented in the entire world, the benefit will go to the whole humankind. So this person is sacrificing his life and his property for the benefit of the whole humankind. So obviously no one can be better than this man. And the hadith is also diverting our attention to spend money in the way of Allah. According to a hadith, Holy Prophet peace be upon him also said that if a person gives money and financial expense to a mujahid, so he will be given the equal reward like that mujahid. For example, if a person is going for jihad, he wants to go for jihad, but he is worried about his family that how will they survive after him. And the other person says that I am taking the responsibility of the financial expenses of your family as long as you will be busy in jihad. So this person will be given the equal reward like that mujahid. So this hadith is encouraging Muslims even today to do certain things in their life. First of all, Muslims need to develop the passion of jihad and they should participate in the physical jihad if there is any opportunity available for them. Because Holy Prophet peace be upon him also said that مَمْ مَاتَ وَلَمْ يَغْزُوا If a person died and he did not do jihad and he did not even encourage himself on jihad so مَاتَ عَلَى شُعْبَةٍ مِنَ النِّفَاقِ So he died on a branch of hypocrisy. If a person has not participated in the physical jihad, at least we should have the desire that if any occasion will come, if any time will come when our life will be needed for the sake of Allah, for the religion of Allah, we will not hesitate in sacrificing our life in the way of Allah. This is a part of Iman. And if we don't think like that, it means that our faith is incomplete. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, himself participated in jihad throughout his Madani life. He 27 times he left Medina for the purpose of physical jihad. In some places battles were fought, in some places the battle didn't take place. But 27 times he left Medina for jihad. And in the Battle of Uhud, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, got injured. And he set an example for the Muslims that until and unless they do jihad in the way of Allah, they cannot live in this world with honor and with dignity, and they cannot maintain their independence if they will not be doing physical jihad. The Holy Quran also said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. Qital is made obligatory on you, though you dislike it. But it may be that you dislike something and it is better for you. So it is just like a medicine. If we will not do that, we cannot live in this world with independence, with honor. And whatever is happening with the Muslim world right now, one of the great reasons is that they are not well prepared for their defense, though it was their responsibility, it was their religious responsibility to be ready for their defense. The Holy Quran says, وَأَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ. Prepare for them what you can afford from power and steeds of war. Steeds of war means the horses which were used in the physical jihad. Today, in place of horses, we need to prepare our submarines and missiles and aircrafts and all these kind of things for our defense, for the defense of the Muslim community. So we should participate in physical jihad in any possible way. If we cannot do that physically, so at least we can do this financially. And even women can participate in jihad financially, and they can earn the huge rewards of jihad in this way. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked the people of Medina for donations at the time of the Tabuk expedition. So Sahaba gave a great example. They set greatest examples of donations in the way of Allah. Like Hazrat Abu Bakr donated everything he had. Hazrat Umar donated half of his wealth and so on. So they set an example for us that how we should participate in the cause of Allah and we should carry out the responsibility of jihad. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.